Welcome to Omega Open Challenge. In this video, we present to you the solution of our first challenge. The challenge was to look at the center of mass of a quarter circular ring of radius r kept in the first quadrant without using calculus. As you can see, this quarter circle is symmetric about a line passing through the origin and at an angle 45 degrees with the horizontal. So the center of mass of the ring must lie on this line. But for any point on this line, its x and y coordinates are always equal. So the x and y coordinates of the center of mass are equal. Now let's bring another identical quarter circular ring and put it in the second quadrant. The center of mass of this quarter ring too must lie on its axis of symmetry. What we now have is a semicircular ring of radius r. The center of mass of this semicircular ring lies on y axis at the coordinate 0, 2r/π. But this center of mass must lie exactly midway between the center of masses of both the quarter rings. Therefore, the center of mass of each ring must lie at height 2r/π. Since the x and y coordinates of the center of mass is to be equal, the coordinates of center of mass of the ring is 2r/π, 2r/π. This is our answer. Sahil Chaudhary from Muzaffarpur and Garvit Virmani from Delhi have used Pepper's centroid theorem to solve the question. Let us first understand Pepper's centroid theorem. Let there be any curve in a plane whose length is L. Let there be an axis which lies in the same plane and does not intersect with the curve. If you rotate the curve about the axis, a three-dimensional surface is generated. Pepper's centroid theorem says that the area of the surface generated is equal to the product of arc length and the distance traveled by its centroid. In case mass is uniformly distributed along the curve, the center of mass lies on the centroid of the curve. Using this result and Pepper's centroid theorem, we can solve this question. The length of the quarter circular ring is π/2 into r. Let the x coordinate of the center of mass of the quarter ring be x. If we rotate it about the y axis, we get a hemisphere whose surface area we know to be 2πr². But when we rotate the ring about y axis, the center of mass travels distance equal to the circumference of the circle, which is 2πx. As per Pepper's centroid theorem, distance traveled by centroid into length of the ring must be equal to the surface area of hemisphere. Putting the values, we get 2πx into π/2r is equal to 2πr². Simplifying, we get x is equal to 2r/π. From symmetry, we know that x and y coordinates of the center of mass are equal. Therefore, the position of center of mass is 2r/π, 2r/π. Shilpa Sonali from Muzaffarpur solved the question using complex number. She divided the ring into several small arcs of infinitesimally small length L. The angle subtended by each arc at the center is L/r. If we assume the mass of π/2r length of ring be m, then mass of each arc is m/π/2r into L or 2ml/πr. Since each arc subtends angle theta at the center, nth arc will be approximately at an angle n theta. Therefore, its mass is at r cos n theta, r sin n theta. The x coordinate of center of mass is given by summation of mi xi divided by summation of mi. Putting the values, we get 2ml/πr into r cos theta plus 2ml/πr into r cos 2 theta up to 2ml/πr into r cos π/2 divided by m. Simplifying, we get 2L/π into cos theta plus cos 2 theta up to cos π/2. Similarly, y coordinate of the center of mass is 2L/π into sin theta plus sin 2 theta up to sin π/2. Multiplying second equation with I and adding, we get x plus iy is equal to 2L/π into cos theta plus I sin theta plus cos 2 theta plus I sin 2 theta up to cos π/2 plus I sin π/2. But cos theta plus I sin theta can be written as e^i θ. So the position of our center of mass in argon plane is 2L/π into e^i θ plus e^2i θ up to e^i π/2. Taking sum of this geometric progression, we get 2L/π into e^i θ into 1 minus e^π/2 divided by 1 minus e^i θ. Putting e^i π/2 equal to I and dividing both numerator and denominator by e^i θ, we get 2L/π into 1 minus I divided by e^-i θ-1. Putting e^-i θ equal to cos theta minus I sin theta, we get 2L/π into 1 minus I divided by cos theta minus I sin theta minus 1. Since theta is very small, cos theta is approximately 1 and sin theta is equal to theta. Putting these values, we get position of center of mass on argon plane as 2L by pi into 1 minus I divided by 1 minus I theta minus 1, or 2L by pi into 1 minus I divided by minus I theta. Theta is L by R, so the position becomes 2L by pi into 1 minus I divided by minus I L by R, or 2R by pi into 1 minus I by I, or 2R by pi into 1 plus I. Therefore, in Cartesian coordinate, the position of center of mass is 2R by pi, 2R by pi. Now it is the time to declare the winner. The winner for the challenge number 1 is Kumar Aniket from Muzaffarpur. Following are the list of other participants submitting the correct solution. You may like our other challenges in this weekly series. The link for the playlist is shown on the screen. Watch our videos on theories, tools and techniques of physics. The link for the playlist is shown on the screen. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel and like our Facebook page for latest updates. Thank you for watching.